And Brandon, moving on into the next team we're taking a look at is the NC State Wolfpack. Too sweet. And the first question I'm going to ask you is plain and simple for this one. Is this team going to challenge Clemson for the top of the Atlantic Division this year? Will they challenge
Clemson?
They're
going to try. They're going to try.
They were only one game behind Clemson last year, and they returned quite a few pieces.
They do.
The main one that they lost is Bradley Chubb, who is no longer in North Carolina. He's now in Denver playing with some higher altitude, but really, they returned some key pieces that could help them challenge for number one in the division.
Yeah, they do. They did lose some pieces, but they still have a lot of guys intact. I mean, they still have their quarterback, Ryan Finley. He's returning again for a sixth season in college. You know, God bless him. He's doing it right. 3,500 yards and 17 touchdowns to only six picks last season. His completion percentage of 65.1%. That's impressive. Mm-hmm. They returned three wide receivers, three offensive linemen. You know, they're really looking at a pretty still very strong offense. Defensively, they lose eight guys. Again, like you said, one of them being the ACC Defensive Player of the Year, Bradley Chubb. Here's the thing. They were 26th against the run last season. They need to keep that about where it is right now. They're 104th against the pass. So that's where things are going to have to get better in the secondary. They're going to need to be better there. But the thing I think is going to come back to the consistency of this team and what they're going to be able to bring and how well Ryan Finley is going to work with this wide receiving core. And then with Reggie Gillespie, he's in there. If he can have an injury-free season, this is a guy who can hit 1,000 yards. I think that with everything that I just mentioned there and a little quick sum up, this is a team that can challenge Clemson. While the task is a tough one, I mean, when we get to Clemson next, we're going to see that they are good. They are good. But I think that NC State and the Wolfpack, I think they're also a very strong team.
The thing I love about this Clemson schedule as I'm looking at it.
This NC State
schedule? NC State schedule. I was clicking on Clemson to see if they don't have to. Actually, I'm going to say the same thing when we get to Clemson, too. You know what's the best part about it? Don't have to see Miami, don't have to see Virginia Tech, and if I see any of them, it's because I beat Clemson on October 20th, and I'm going to the ACC title game, baby. Like, that is the best part about this, because we talk about Finley, but this wide receiver group that he has, he is on record saying, and this is a quote from Athlon Sports, where they say, he said, there's no doubt we have the best receiving core in the ACC.
Yeah.
So, to me, there's basically how this is going to go down in the Atlantic this year is, now I know Clemson fans are going to be like, well, we have an offense too, but for me, in my mind, it is going to be, I cannot wait until October 20th because it will be the great offense of the ACC and NC State against probably the best Clemson defense we have seen for some time in Clemson. And I can't wait for that game at Clemson because it is going to be great defense on one end, great offense on the other. Which team is going to prevail? Last year for NC State, they only had three losses all year. You lose to Notre Dame, you lose to Wake Forest, you lose to Clemson. This year, you don't have to worry about that Wake Forest loss. There's only two teams on the schedule that I could see beating NC State. September 15th, when they host the West Virginia Mountaineers, that's going to be a very good Mountaineer team that Sean and I, when we previewed the top half of the Big 12 last week, West Virginia was a team that I looked at as could be a sneaky team in the Big 12 to finish maybe top three, maybe even sneak up there to be a sleeper team to kind of get into the top two, even though I still think it'll be between OU, Texas, and TCU. and then Clemson. Those are the only two games on the schedule. I don't see anyone else in the – now, I know, like, the Boston College, I'll give a shot. Syracuse, if they play as well as they did last year against Clemson, that game is going to be at Syracuse. So any given Saturday, any given Sunday, however you want to say it, everyone has a puncher's chance. But those are the only two games that I see them losing, because I look at two of the games that they're playing from the Coastal. And if I am NC State, I am hugging the schedule makers and I am giving them a big old fat kiss on the forehead, because you didn't give me the Miami Hurricanes. You didn't give me the Virginia Tech Hokies. You gave me the Virginia Cavaliers. Thank you. And you gave me the North Carolina Tar Heels. Thank you again. So, I mean, this team, I think that this schedule is going to come down to, do you beat West Virginia? Doesn't matter really, because it could be like a OU kind of OSU game where it's like, oh, you know, you lost that one, but you won everything else. When it comes to the playoffs, that's the only thing that loss would really matter in. And then really it comes down to, all they have to do, take care of business, win on October 20th, and this team's playing either against Virginia Tech or Miami for the ACC title and possibly a playoff berth.
Yeah, I think this team has a lot to be really excited about. They return again a lot of players on the offensive side. You have your quarterback, which, you know, when you have your quarterback already and you don't have any question marks,
it's the most important position on the field.
So important. It's so important for the skill and ability. It's important for the leadership.
Mm-hmm.
And they have that. And this guy has all of that.
Mm-hmm.
You have your top receivers. You've got Kelvin Harmon. 69 catches last year, over 1,000 yards, 4 touchdowns. Add onto those touchdowns, get it to about 1,100, 1,200 yards. We're talking about a great season. He had a good season this past year. He could have a great season. Junior Jacoby Myers. This guy's going to be a deep ball threat. He had 63 catches, 727 yards, 5 touchdowns last year. Add on to that, again, you keep Reggie Gillespie healthy. If he stays healthy, he gets 1,000 yards. You're looking at another piece who's going to be very, very important to this offense. Add in 4-star recruit Ricky Person. Pearson, it looks like Person. I tried to look up videos to say it. They didn't say it. So, yeah, I know. It's
NC
on me.
State fans, but let us know, baby.
Ricky, he's a guy who's got great speed and big play ability.
You know he's great because he's got my first name.
Yes. Yes. I wonder if his alter ego is Dick as well.
Maybe. Maybe.
It could be. But I think that they've got the playmakers offensively. I'm not worried about them offensively. And I shouldn't say that I'm worried at all about them defensively either. And I don't want to say at all.
It always hurts when you lose the best player in the conference to the NFL draft.
It does.
A guy that was so good that the team that drafted him at, what, 4 or 5, the defensive coordinator's chin hit the floor when the team at number 1 didn't draft him.
Well, here I'll say this. Like I mentioned earlier, they were 104th against the pass last year. They also were plagued by injuries and inexperience. They now have a year under their belt. The guy should be healthy. They should be much better. They should be much better. They've got Nick McCloud, who's going to be returning. They also get a transfer from Tennessee and Stephen Griffin, who's going to help out back there in the secondary as well. I don't see these guys being as bad as they were in terms of ranking last year on defense against the pass. You know, it really does take a toll on you when you have injuries, and then you add that to inexperience. I think we look for them to take a leap this year, and with that leap, maybe they are putting a little bit more pressure on Clemson, because what has Clemson showed the last two seasons? They are going to be upset by someone.
Yeah, and the big thing, the only thing looking at their schedule that could probably be like the, oh, great, we didn't get everything in our favor, is that Clemson game is in Death Valley.
Yeah.
It's on the road at Clemson. It is one of the hardest places to not only win a football game, but play a football game.
Death Valley?
Yeah, them and LSU are both Death Valley. I know. It feels weird saying because I always think of LSU first, but yeah, it's Death Valley as well.
I always wanted to call them Happy Valley.
You run down the hill, you touch the stone,
I knew Death Valley was LSU, yeah. But I guess I wasn't so... You shocked me a little bit when you said that about Clemson.
I want to say it's Death Valley. Let me look it up just to make sure. Brandon keeping me on my toes that I'm right. I could be right. I could be wrong. I'll look it up in a second. But, I mean, this team, these are the last two that are the easiest previews for me because I don't think Clemson and NC State are going to lose many games. The one loss I forgot to mention from last year was South Carolina, and the only reason I forget to mention that one is because I remember watching that game because I was visiting a friend in Wisconsin, and we were out to eat, and it was on the television set, and I remember watching it. I was the only one at the table watching it because the other people that I was with were more of the nerd variety and not the sports fan variety. It's more like going out to lunch with Johnny. Johnny's not going to look at a football game or a basketball
sports.
Game. Sports with a huge exclamation point was basically the type of friends I was with. So I'm the only one watching this. And there was a play late in that game, a fourth down where I believe they ran it or Finley quarterback sneaked it. They converted, but they didn't get it. It was a bullshit call, and I remember bitching about it at the table to people that knew nothing of what I was bitching about. But that's why that one kind of squeaks by, because you shouldn't have lost that game in my mind. But it doesn't matter. You don't have to play them this year. And for me, the only non-conference game that could be a loss is that West Virginia game. Other than that, it's the Clemson game. Like, Boston College, I get. They're better on paper. I don't think they'll beat NC State. Florida State, Seminole fans will want to tell me, yeah, we're going to upset them. I don't think that happens. Wake Forest, oh, we beat them last year. You're not the same team. You're not the same offense that you were last year. So for me, I feel like this division comes down to, and really it never does, but in my mind I'm going to say it again, it comes down to October 20th. Whoever wins that football game will most likely be the one to represent the ACC Atlantic in the ACC title game and will have the best shot to win a winner-take-all to possibly make the playoff out of the Power 5 teams.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. That's why that game at Clemson is going to be very important. And you're right, it is Death Valley. Happy Valley is Penn State. I don't know how I got that confused. But that is going to be the number one game. And the reason being is because of what you said. Mm-hmm. They could easily, NC State, could easily beat West Virginia. Mm-hmm. And if that happens, there is a good argument that could be made that they beat everyone else on their schedule, mm-hmm. and then you come to that Clemson game. And the same is probably going to be said when you look at Clemson's schedule, and I know that Clemson is next, but you look at Clemson's schedule, I won't say it out loud, mm-hmm. but you look at it and you could see, mm-hmm. yeah, the game that most people are going to be looking at and circling is NC State. Most people. Mm-hmm. Some people may be looking at game two, but we'll talk about that more when we get to it. Yeah. But it makes sense, and that's why what you say has a lot of weight to it,
mm-hmm.
because it really is going to come down, and the fate of the Atlantic could really be decided by one game.
The big thing that I love about NC State over Clemson, and I know that these two are so closely linked that it's like you kind of don't want to give anything away of what we're going to end the podcast with. But with NC State, I'll say it this way. The thing I love most about them is everything that they return. I know that we talked about, I can't even remember, they're all kind of mushing together at this point. Oh, it was Louisville. I know it's kind of the same thing with Louisville. Oh, this one's a little different because they returned their quarterback. Juwan Pass wasn't the starter last year, but they returned their starting quarterback. They return their receiving core. Yet it's not like, oh, man, but that defense is a bunch of basically a bag of crap, like we said, with Louisville. Like, they're going to have a really good offense, and the defense, yeah, they're going to have to replace, what, 7 or 8 players, but they're going to replace those players. And to me, I think the question will come down to, when it comes down to NC State-Clemson, is for NC State, the question will be, how do they replace those defensive starters and those defensive players that are now gone? Compared to Clemson, which basically, and we're going to get into this in a second, basically Trevor Lawrence versus Kelly Bryant. The quarterback position is yet another question. It's always been a question since Deshaun Watson left. So in that game, which is going to be the bigger question, which is going to be the weakest link, the defense that NC State has to replace, or the quarterback question that Clemson may have this year? That's what ultimately, in the end, could decide the ACC and the ACC Atlantic.
Yeah, I think you're completely right, and I think that with what you said, we're looking at, with NC State, a lot of returners, mm-hmm. and a lot of returners offensively. And what you said with Clemson, again, you know, like you said, we don't really want to get into it too much because that's the next one, but they are so close together here. It's going to be a quarterback battle, but I don't think it's going to be a quarterback battle for long, and we'll talk about that when we get to it. But it's going to be two very good teams battling it out in what will hopefully and most likely be a very good, close game.
Last thing I'll ask you for NC State on their side. How do you see their wins and losses panning out? Because for me, the way I'm going to go is probably safe, even though I'm probably going to be rooting for them more so than Clemson. I think they lose to Clemson, and that's the only game they lose all year. They lose one game all year, and I will even throw this into the pot. If Clemson makes it to the ACC title game, and God forbid a team not Virginia Tech or Miami makes it to that ACC title game, and then Clemson loses, we will then be talking about NC State should be getting into the playoff, much like we saw with the Big Ten a couple years ago. But I don't think that'll happen. I just think it'll be one loss. They'll get a New Year's Six bowl game, and they'll probably watch Clemson at that point go to the playoff.
Unfortunately, I am agreeing with what you are saying. I think they'll also be 11-1, and I think Clemson will be the team that they lose to.
I mean, West Virginia, I almost want to give, like, I want to give them a puncher's chance, but the thing,
because of Will Grier?
He's the reason why I kind of go back a little bit, because I like Finley more than Grier, and Grier's got an injury history. Like, one wrong hit in that game, and he's toasto, donezo, out of that game. And then
toasto.
NC State carries off with the win. So, I mean, that's why with them, I'm going to give the ball to NC State. But any final thoughts before we move on into those Tigres?
Let's hit the Tigres.
This is where you guys come in. Let us know what you think down below in the comment section about the NC State Wolfpack. Will they win the ACC? Will they beat Clemson? How well or how good will their season be this year? Let us know what you think down below in the comment section.